Hey guys, I'm LB. We are back playing the Talos Principle on BFF. Last episode, we froze the robot up here in the air, blew it with the fan into the turret, and it blew it up. So now we don't need to use this on the turret anymore. We can go wherever we want. Alright, so, let's get some things clear here. This can go here. That's a odd sideways jump. And we can use this, we can use the fan to put pressure on these pressure plates, so that'll be useful, right? And we'll get these boxes over here too. And also, we'll use, we'll do this. Which side is it? Right there. So, we just need to move this guy now. Okay, so there's that, right? Interesting. I wonder what's up with that. How are we gonna get a red laser over here? That's gonna be interesting. How do we get one here? Now, do this, right? What's the purpose of this? Who knows? Yeah, okay, so that turns that off. How's that supposed to work? Yeah, I'm not understanding the angles involved here. Cause our laser guy... Alright, did I die? I died, that's right. The robot killed me at one point, so we gotta go fix the laser guy. Thank you. Okay, so there's that. Not really working. Yeah, it's like, it's almost like I need to be back here or something. That's not gonna happen, though. I mean, we do have this box. No, it still doesn't really... Serious. Okay, well, I guess we just have to try solving the puzzle for now. Like, what's the point of this? And what even turns it on? Yeah, okay, I can do that, but that doesn't really do me any good. Those clouds look nice. Huh. That's interesting, why does it have an assisted jump there? Does this also want to assist my jump there? That is weird. Because that's the other side of the barrier. But this is on the... make any sense to me. Ha ha! I would have to reset the puzzle if that worked, so thankfully it doesn't work. I was just curious. I am thoroughly confused right now. What is this fan for? Oh, right, right, right. I want to see something. So if we do this, right? Well, that's something. What does this allow us to do now? Not quite. Oh, here we go. Ta-da! It's like magic! Thank you. Ta-da! Hello, the blacksmith. It's the one who never talks. Okay, well, I want to go up to the lasers now, the one up the, up there, and see if we can see the laser from where we are. I'm gonna follow him as well. Oh, okay, he's going that way. These scripted jumps are kind of weird. All right, we're hearing the computer below us. How are we going to get an angle on this? It's not quite working. I mean, I could lift it up a little bit higher with the box, but... Oh, I didn't even see this here. Well, this is clearly how we get that star. Try it. Extra box? No, it's still not high enough. Interesting. I don't know. Well, let's read our mail. We'll read one of these and then we'll end the episode. I started writing the next episode, but suddenly, I don't know whether to continue. I mean, what's the point? It's over. It's all over. Yeah, so I guess all of this will be remembered. Brave soul who ascended the tower, or who wakes up outside Elohim's garden, will know everything we know. I think that's what it'll be like. That's what the shepherd meant in those messages. But you and me, we won't exist. Not as people, not as minds. No matter what happens, I will never be able to finish the adventures of Jefferson Goldblum. Does one more episode matter? I had the story planned out all the way to episode 500. I can never get there before the end. What's the point of an unfinished legacy? And still, I can't quite give up. I know I don't have the blacksmith's vision or Mr. Multiple's intelligence, but this stupid story matters to me. I care about Jefferson Goldblum and Ginny HD and Freaky Soy Sauce and all the other characters as if they were my friends. I would have gone crazy here without them and their adventures. They may just be symbols on a screen, but aren't we all just information? Maybe when we ascend, we won't be that different anymore. I just don't want to give up on them. Mac, I just want to say this, no matter what happens, I looked forward to every one of your stories, and they meant more to me than I perhaps ever indicated. They might not have moved as deeply as others, or made me think as much, but of all the art we produced here in Gehenna, it was your stories I was always the most excited to see. Part of it was the stories themselves, which always seemed to make the universe seem bigger. Another part was your genuine enthusiasm with what you were doing. You told me once that you didn't feel you were really a proper artist, but maybe the exact opposite is true. Maybe you were closer to the real meaning of art than anyone else here. I cared about you and your stories, and that too will be remembered. Well guys, thank you for watching. If you hate the sound of my voice, leave a dislike, it's up to you. And I will see you all in the next episode. Goodbye!